and Rachel seem awfully serious. I wonder if something's gone wrong with the Easter egg hunt.
I somehow don't think that's it exactly.
Matthew, we asked you a question.
What do you mean he wasn't at school? What does she mean you weren't at school?
Jeez, everyone is getting worked up.
What about... say we knock off the Ferris Bueller bit and get some straight answers right now?
I think maybe this is the perfect time for me to make an exit, Loretta. Would you tell Mac and Rachel I will call them later?
Well, right? What about the Easter egg hunt? They're giving the prizes out at 4.
Right, you're right. I'm sure you can do this without me, can't you?
Maybe I could give out the prizes and make a little speech.
Oh, that would be very nice. Great, okay. Oh, nice. Have fun, all right. Oh, Hildy, it's all right. I'm going to go to the door anyway. Bye. Madge, you're here.
I can never put one over on you, can I?
You know what? I think my day is going to pick up right from here.
Well, I've come to take you away from all of this.
You know, Felicia, the one thing I thought I could say is something about... Oh, Mitch, you're back.
What's she doing here?
Mitch.
Matthew, I'm not kidding. I want to know what you've been up to this last week, and I want to know now.
Well, see, look who's here. Dad!
Dad, you want to call me Dad when you want something?
This is great. You just couldn't have showed up at a better time. Look who's here. Just in time for the party.
This can't be happening. I don't believe this.
I know!
But people get locked out of buildings. They don't get locked inside.
Well, Jamie, we're not really locked in.
The door is jammed. It won't open. What do you call it?
Well, even if we are locked in, I'm sure you can do something about it, right?
Yeah. You know, if I had a ladder, I could reach those windows.
Ooh, I don't see one around.
You could pry them open somehow, you know?
Now, Jamie, what's the big deal, huh?
What?
Well, things could be a whole lot worse, right?
This doesn't bother you?
Of course not. Nothing bothers me, Jamie. I'm fine. You're fine. We're just fine, right? Hi, Mr. McKinnon. You look really snazzy.
Oh, thanks. Mary call here, Mrs. McKinnon?
No, why?
Well, I was supposed to meet her over at St. Elmo's. The kids were doing a Sunday school thing for Easter, you know.
Didn't she show up?
No, that's not like her.
Gee, I hope nothing's wrong.
Yeah. So do I.
You got spunk.
And you have a hell of a nerve.
And you took a long time to stop.
If I didn't stop you right away, it's only because it took me a split second to realize that anybody could be that obnoxious, even you.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Mary, what do you keep coming around for then, huh?
Because I felt sorry for you.
Oh, come on.
Because you were alone.
You're alone?
No, no, I'm not. No, I have my children. I have friends. I have Vince.
And Vince.
And you pretend to be his friend.
No, I am his friend.
Is that how you show friendship? By forcing yourself on the woman.
The woman of what? What?
You know how it is with us.
Yeah, I got a pretty good idea, but why don't you tell me?
We were married. We had 4 children together. We buried one of those children together.
I know all about that.
And I still care for him, and I demand that you respect that.
I know exactly how you feel about Vince.
Good.
He's a great guy.
He's more than that.
Yeah. He's safe. There's a very big part of you that cries out for anything but safe.
It's none of your business how I feel about Vince. Don't you dare ever touch me like that again. And don't you ever tell yourself that you did it because I liked it.
Mary.
You disgust me.
Somebody should be in with our guests.
The guests can take care of themselves.
Well, so can I. I don't need you two hanging around looking after me.
Yes, you do. You look like you're about to spit nails.
Yes, well, I am. Did you see what Matthew did? He used a social situation to avoid talking to us. That's not Matthew. He was sly and underhanded.
Are you sure he left school early?
Well, if I wasn't sure before, I am now. Mac, you shouldn't have let him get away with this.
Darling, that's his father in there. This is a delicate situation.
I'm sorry. I wasn't thinking. Well, that child might be able to avoid us now, but he can't avoid us forever.
So was it great down there? Did you have a great time?
It's different. Interesting.
Just interesting. I thought there was some...
How about you? How were exams?
Well, we haven't got the grades back yet, but I think I did really well.
Math, any problems?
Nope. Did great. Love them logarithms. Hey, I got an idea. Why don't we all go out to eat? I can't wait to hear about your trip.
Oh, isn't it wonderful? He wants to spend time with you.
It's wonderful, huh?
But why don't you come with us? Just one big happy family. Felicia, what do you say?
What's going on?
Nothing. Nothing at all.
You've just been taken with an overwhelming desire to dine with us all?
Mitch, he hasn't seen you in weeks.
Loretta.
Well, you should be flattered that he wants to spend time with you.
You know what, Loretta? Why don't we leave them alone for a little while?
Well, if the boy is having trouble with Mac and Rachel, maybe talking to Mitch...
Is there trouble with Mac and Rachel?
No, not at all. It's just that I'm not crazy about this Easter egg hunt.
I'll talk to them.
Mitch, I really do think that I
don't care what you think. Or should you and I have a talk first?
People are going to start coming in now.
We'll talk to Matthew later, Rachel.
Yes, and Amanda.
Amanda? Who do you think was covering for Matthew through all of this? Of course she knew about this. She's known about it all along.
Darling, I know you're upset.
Of course I'm upset. Two of our children are in collusion over something we know nothing about. And Amanda, I'm more than upset about Amanda knowing about all of this. She's the one that says that she's so mature and can handle things. And then she goes and does something like this.
Hello, Julianne.
Oh, I'm sorry. I should have gone around the front.
No, no, no. It's just such a beautiful day. We thought we should be out here.
Well, I'll go check this in. It was a lot of fun.
Thank you.
Now I have to go in and count eggs.
If you're trying to hide something, if it's a cover-up, I'm going to find out.
I don't know what everyone is getting so uptight about.
I'm going to go talk to your mom and Mac.
Well, I guess he wasn't hungry. Yeah. Well, I guess I'll just head off here. No.
I wouldn't bet on it, Matthew.
He won't give me a straight answer.
I'm back. Hi, Mitch.
Hi.
Look, I found the special egg.
It's all very good. Nice. It's all right.
You can see you're thrilled.
No, it's wonderful. Hello,
it's
Adam.
It's wonderful, sweetie.
Oh, what's wrong?
No, nothing.
Well, I guess I'll just go in and tell Jamie he got the easy map.
Isn't Jamie with you?
Oh, no, we were going to meet here.
I haven't seen him.
You mean he's not back yet? He must be having problems with his riddles.
It's no use.
Oh, come on, there's got to be a latch up there you can pry open or something.
Jamie, there's nothing. I don't think these windows were meant to be open.
Oh, great.
Build a boathouse like this anyway, huh?
I don't know. I'm gonna look around. Maybe I can find something to pry the hinges off the door with.
Yeah, I'll check out the door too. What's the matter with this? I planned this whole thing.
What'd you say?
Oh, I said you probably think I planned this whole thing.
Oh, no. Thought never crossed my mind.
Well, that's good. Jamie, I hope Lisa's not worried about you.
Oh, are you kidding? She's probably snagged up every egg in the county and is so flush with victory that... I don't believe this.
What?
I found an Easter egg.
Oh, isn't that great?
But this is all I found. I guess we're just gonna have to wait.
I guess we are.
I mean, you know, somebody's bound to come by, right? Lisa, she knew where I was headed, so we just wait.
Right, so what do you
think we can do until then?
Well, I can think of only one thing.
Me too.
There's an extra bucket over there with a sponge. We might as well get to work.
This can't be happening.
Did you say something?
No, nothing. I said, actually, I'm glad you're not worried.
Worried? What? We're stuck in a boathouse. What's the big deal? It's not the end of the world, is it?
No, right.
I mean, you know, even Lisa's got to find this funny. I mean, yeah, who in their right mind would set something like this up, right?
Right, who in their right mind?
Steer people the other way so you can stay here and talk.
Well, it's not going to be easy with people coming and going.
Well, I'll try to buy you 5 and 10 minutes so you can be alone.
Thank you.
Thanks, sir. What's the problem?
Matthew. He's been in Bay City a while, staying at Amanda's.
He what?
He left school early. He's been hiding out over there.
We're not sure, Rachel.
The reason we're not sure is because he's not talking to us. He used your arrival as another dodge.
Well, he hasn't exactly been straight with me either.
You think something's wrong?
We should just sit down and talk to him.
Yes, and he's going to do everything he can to avoid that.
They'll be in soon. They're out there discussing egg hunt rules.
I don't know where Jamie could be.
You're not worried about him, are you?
No, I just was wondering where he was.
So, use your power, you know, sort of like zero in on it.
Adam, I wouldn't use my psychic ability to spy on my boyfriend. Oh. Is there an article of Jamie's clothing about here?
I know I make him mad. I know he doesn't want me to say anything, but...
Loretta, it's just that Mitch is a very private man. You know, it's not easy for him to talk about his relationship with Matthew, even with me.
And I'm not exactly mother of the year, so what right do I have to butt in, you know?
I just think that you and Mitch should take things very slowly.
You see, I knew Matthew was pulling a con, but at least he wanted to spend time with Mitch. My kids, well, it's not their fault they never wanted to spend time with me.
You know, I think all of that can change, you know, the right amount of time.
I don't know. The first words out of his mouth was, what is she doing here?
Maybe he'll find out that all you really want is time to see him.
You're not a bit dumb, are you?
Just don't push. You know, Mitch is not the kind of guy that you can push into anything.
You're telling me not to be pushy. That's like telling Joan Rivers not to talk.
I can't believe this. I got all them on my case, now you.
Listen to me. Amanda's having enough trouble now. She doesn't need any more aggravations.
What?
I overheard your mom. And she's mad at Amanda because Amanda's covering up for you. Before you leave this house today, you better square it away with your parents.
Look, you don't understand.
Let me put it another way. I don't care what you did or didn't do. That's not the issue. If you love your sister, you would tell your mother that Amanda had nothing to do with this escapade, whatever it was. Amanda needs your parents' support right now, Matthew. And you know as well as I do that you're the only one in this whole world that she would lie for.
I hate it when I have to do the right thing.
Amanda's done right by you many times.
Oh, yeah, she has.
I heard that.
What?
You're tired. Come on, why don't you take a nap?
No, I'm fine.
So when are you gonna start?
Start what?
You know, dressing like a pregnant lady, walking around looking like a mushroom.
I can hardly wait.
Look, I saw this great store in the mall. It's got these really cool clothes in the window. Probably won't make you look like a mushroom at all.
I really don't need new clothes. I'm fine.
This isn't about vanity, is it? You're worried about the money.
No, really, that isn't it.
Come on, Amanda, if you need clothes, we can get you clothes.
Can we please talk about something else?
Sorry?
Look, I know everything's gonna work out great. You're gonna sell a painting pretty soon.
Yeah, sure.
And then I can get whatever clothes I need.
Where you been?
On the barn.
Where's Cheryl?
She went home. Saw Mary tearing out of here.
Yep.
She really smoking those tires, wasn't she?
Yeah, well, she's in a big hurry.
You want to tell me what happened?
What about Mary?
Yeah, we could start there.
No, I don't really feel like talking about it.
Ah. Well, it looks like the plan to save Frame Construction fell through, huh?
I told you, I'm taking care of that.
Like you took care of Mary?
Oh, what are you talking about?
Come on, it's pretty obvious she was upset when she left here.
Yeah, well, Mary gets upset about the least little thing, John.
You just don't care, do you?
Hey, I will run my life. Why don't you run your own?
Well, I'd like to do that, but our lives seem to be a little tied together right now, and I'm sick of not getting any answers.
I'm sick of you, too. You know that?
Fine.
Bringing that briefcase up to Jamie the other night.
Well, you still haven't told me the truth about that.
I won it playing poker. You just won't accept that.
Well, you're damn straight I'm not going to accept that.
Probably why Jamie won't accept it and why you won't even talk to me about Frame Construction right now.
You are a real piece of work, you know that? You expect them to turn the title of the company over to you just because you want it?
Yeah, I want it.
Well, maybe they're sick of being kept in the dark about the reasons why.
Like you are, huh?
Yeah, like I am. I'm sick of that. And I'm also sick of you changing the subject every time I start talking about legal papers for a partnership. And I'm sick of you playing everybody for a sucker. Not thinking about anything except about what you want.
Hey, you're so sick of it. Why don't you just get out?
Well, that's always an option.
John, I would think of anybody you would have understood.
Understood what?
What it's like to live in the shadow of your big brother, a big brother who always does everything right.
Oh, yeah, that number.
It's not a number.
Sure it is. I'm real familiar with it. You do anything you want to whomever you want, and then you let yourself off the hook because Mom always liked him best.
Michael didn't die.
That's a fact.
When I got that bloody telegram, I couldn't believe it. My life struggle is over like that. I win by default.
Is that why you want to run his company?
Spent so many years trying to be like him. No, trying to be better than him, hating myself because I couldn't do it. Yeah, I want to run this company my way. And I want to do it better. That's kind of like working things out for me.
You know, you're right.
About what?
I do understand.
Good.
But I have a question.
About what?
Is all this just a line of bull?
You plan on sticking around?
I might do that.
But I meant every breath of it. Hey, I'm gonna get out of these Sunday duds. I think Easter's about over, isn't it?
I think so. Listen, that woman ever call back?
Huh?
Well, I figured she might have called while Mary was here, and that's what upset her.
What woman?
I don't know. Some woman that called this morning. She wouldn't leave her name.
Well, you're going to have to get used to that. You hang around me, the women pester me all the time.
Must be a real burden.
I'll try to live with it. It means I don't worry about Mary. She gets upset about nothing. She's fine.
There you were.
I went to St. Elmo's, but they told me you had already left.
Yeah, well, it was only a, you know, Sunday school pageant. I didn't want to go to Sardi's and wait for the reviews.
You're angry.
No, I'm not. Not everybody is a sucker for a five-year-old dressed as Mary Magdalene. I may be the only one.
I really wanted to be there with you.
Oh, well, good. That's the thoughts that, you know, that counts.
I had to go to Jason's.
Okay.
I had to pick up our tickets. It's not just...
He runs a travel agency now?
No, I had left them there.
Okay.
And I had to get them because I didn't want anything to ruin our trip together.
You've been looking for the tickets all this time?
Well, no. No, I kept trying to leave, but you know Jason.
No, I don't, Mary. Damn it. Don't you think I care about you? I was worried about you. You should have called.
You're right. I'm terribly sorry. Sometimes I'm not a very good person.
I hate when you do that.
What?
Admit you're wrong so fast.
Are you gonna stay mad at me, or are you gonna give me something to eat?
What's the matter with that guy? Didn't he feed you?
No.
All right, I can put you into an Easter Sunday special, all right?
Okay.
Mary's place. Oh, yeah, she's right here. Theo.
Where's it?
Dr. Jackson from the hospital.
Hello. No, you're not bothering me at all. Tomorrow? No, I'm just surprised there has to be another interview. Oh, thank you. Yes, of course. I'll be there. Okay. Oh, yes, of course. Bye. I'll have to go in tomorrow for another interview.
That's the job, right?
Yeah. Yeah, he said I seem to be exactly what they need.
Hey, I could have told him.
Yeah, I have to be met by somebody who's on the board of governors or directors.
Well, good luck.
There's one little problem.
What?
If I do get the job, it starts next week.
Next week?
Our trip.
You know, this day is getting better and better.
So that's when I asked Amanda to cover for me. And I know I shouldn't have done that.
But you did take your exams.
Yeah, they let me take them early. I wrote a note saying I had to get back home. I signed your name.
You forged a note signed by us?
Our school has strict rules about letting us go early.
And you broke those rules, as well as one of the most important rules of this family.
You said a lot of things that weren't truthful.
I just needed some time to think about my future and stuff. I didn't know what else to do.
Didn't you think about talking to your family?
I should have. I know. I'm sorry.
Well, thank you for finally being honest with us. Now, what do you suppose we ought to do to deal with you?
Okay, it's 4 o'clock, guys. There are people waiting for you inside.
All right, we'll be in a minute.
Well, if you guys are going to be busy, maybe I'll go into town.
No, not so fast, pal. I think under the circumstances, you ought to have a quiet evening at home, helping us come up with some appropriate punishment for all this dishonesty.
Right. All right.
Did you get it settled?
No. Let's go count eggs.
These kids are really gonna love you.
Huh?
From St. Elmo's, the kids you're cleaning this boat for.
Oh, yeah, right.
It's really not that bad of a boat. It's just too bad somebody hasn't taken care of it.
No, Jamie, have you heard anything out there?
No.
Don't you think it's a little strange that we've been in here all this time and we haven't heard a thing out there?
It's a holiday.
What's that supposed to mean? Do you really think we're going to be in here until tomorrow?
It means that most normal people aren't scrubbing down a boat on Easter Sunday.
Oh, now are you trying to say that I'm not normal?
Well, if the shoe fits.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah? Shoe fits, huh?
Yeah.
Wear it.
Did you ever make the biggest mistake of your life?
No, don't,
oh, yes.
Jamie, don't,
oh, yes.
Don't say that. No, please, don't. Jamie, don't say that!
Come on.
Jamie!
Vicky!
okay. It's okay. Come on, come over and sit down. Come on. Come on. Come on, it's gonna be okay. It's gonna be okay. Come on, come on, sit down. Come on. Come on, it's all right. It's okay. It's okay. It's gonna be okay. Why didn't you tell me you had claustrophobia?
I didn't know.
This has never happened before?
No, if it did, the whole day would have gone a lot differently.
I'll just try to calm down.
I don't think I can calm down, Jamie.
I'll try to think of something else.
No, I can think of the doors, and the doors are caving in on me, and the walls, are going to come down.
You're freezing. I'll get a blanket.
Oh, Amy thought the water fight would help. It was a brilliant idea, Vicky.
There's a blanket. It's okay. There
you go. Thank you.
It's all right.
Oh.
Just try to think of something else, okay?
Yeah, something else.
You know. You know, you've been a really big help to Michael and Donna lately.
Yeah, well, they've been through a lot, Jamie.
Yes, yes. I know how much they wanted that baby.
Yeah. It wasn't for dear old grandfather with both of those pregnant.
What is it?
Donna. When she was pregnant with Marley and me, she was locked up in a basement and she couldn't get out.
And now you can't stand being locked in.
It's amazing how something like that will stick with you.
Yeah, yeah, well, we're all afraid of something, huh?
What are you afraid of?
Oh, me, I'm afraid of not having any money when the bills come in.
No, I'm serious. I really want to know.
Well, okay. I'm afraid of life not really meaning anything. That it's just one day in front of the other, you know?
Until you die.
Yeah, you know.
Yeah.
That's one of the reasons I became a doctor, to fight that feeling.
And, does it work?
Most of the time.
You know, I never figured you to be the type that was afraid of anything.
How are you feeling now?
Better. Much better,
good.
Thanks.
Good.
Can't we at least talk about it?
There's nothing to talk about.
You know I want to take this trip with you.
And I also know jobs like this don't come along that often.
Fitz, I feel terrible.
Why? Because you missed a Sunday school pageant and a trip that I arranged without asking.
But I want to do these things with you. I do.
Thank you both for the ride. There's no telling when Jamie would be back.
No problem, Amy. Really, no problem.
Listen, let me give you something to eat.
No, really.
Oh, come on. Sit down. One good turn.
Okay. We don't have to stay very long.
That's okay.
All right?
That's okay.
I missed you a lot.
It's good to be back. I'm sorry to hear about that, isn't it? Losing your baby, and I'm sorry that I wasn't here.
Me too. You know, though, it made me think.
Can you think and open a present all at the same time?
I don't know. That's a toughie. I could try, but wait a minute. A llama couldn't possibly fit in that bag.
No, well, it's not a llama.
Mitch, this isn't tacky.
No, it's not.
Look on this child's face. Did you take this?
Mm-hmm. I guess it all just got to me. Country's torn apart. The poverty is incredible. And yet there's that wonderful look of hope on his face.
Yeah, I can see it in his eyes.
I'm glad I took that while that look is still there.
You know what? I don't think that I really appreciate how talented you are.
No, you probably don't.
You know, maybe you should enter this in a contest or something.
No, that one's for you.
I love you.
Not too bad yourself, you know?
Oh, thank you. What's the matter? You still thinking about Matthew?
No, no.
Yes, you are. Mitch, come on.
Look, I'm not going to know anything until I talk to Sam, so I'm not going to worry about it. I'm going to just let it be for the time being.
So why don't you go over and see Sam and talk to him?
Because I want to be with you.
You are with me. Believe me, I'm not getting rid of you that quick. But go on, go talk to Sam. You'll feel better. I'll explain it to Amy. Go on, go on.
I'll be back.
Okay, don't worry. I'll be just fine.
See you. Yeah, we're
great. I'm sorry. I'm worked up, okay?
Yeah, I can tell.
I mean, I just got back into town, and I go over, and I find that Mom's still here. Something's going on with Matthew, and, I mean, I've seen Felicia all of 30 seconds, maybe.
It's okay, Mitch. It's okay. It's good to see you.
What's going on with Matthew? I mean, has he been staying here? Do you know anything?
Look, I know a little bit about it, okay? That's all.
I mean, is he all right? Is there any big deal?
No, it's not a big deal. I think he's okay.
Good.
Yeah, so look, I got something to ask you, talk to you about this.
What is Mom doing here? Is she bothering you?
No.
Well, if she's in your hair, just let me know and I'll...
Mitch, it's not that, okay?
I don't know. I go over to the Corey's house. I mean, she's there. I don't believe Rachel is putting up with her.
Just keep it down, okay, Mitch?
Okay. You're right. I'll get out of here.
No!
Look, I guess I'm asleep. I will talk later.
Yeah, right.
I'm sorry to barge in.
It's okay, man. Good to see you.
You were right about the paints. Yeah. I got everything that you wanted. They were cheaper there.
Oh, right. I forgot I asked.
It's going to be $120. I'll bring them by tomorrow.
Okay. Yeah, thanks a lot.
Tell Amanda hi.
Sure will.
See you later.
$20. I'm calling about the ad tomorrow. Can I talk to somebody today? Yeah, right. I forgot about the holiday. Great. Happy Easter to you, too. Take care of you. I promise.
Mitch is worried about Matthew, too.
Where is Matthew?
Upstairs. I should get used to it by now. I mean, it happens with all the children. They get to the point where they just don't talk to their parents. It happened with Jamie. It happened with Amanda. I shouldn't get upset by it.
We have to get upset. That's our job.
So... what happened was, Matthew left school early so that he would have time to think about his future.
It's plausible.
Yes. Plausible.
Like the time Jamie borrowed the family car in order to deliver the school literary magazine.
And came home at 3 o'clock in the morning.
And we know how much Matthew likes to sit around thinking about his future.
You don't buy it at all, do you?
Not for a second.
So then I told them I needed some time to think. Of course they believe me. I'm their kid. They believe what I say.
Place that you saw him, huh?
Yes, we were standing right there talking to a guy in a tuxedo.
A tuxedo?
Mm-hmm. He was saying that I should go off and follow my map and find this special egg, and Jamie should stay here and follow his map, which probably was not a good idea because Jamie's not very good at maps.
And Jamie never returned.
Oh, wait a minute. You don't think he gave in to temptation, do you? Stole the Easter eggs, could seal the airports, throw up roadblocks.
Jamie wouldn't do that.
Too honorable, huh?
No, he couldn't read the map to get out of town. Oh.
Well, I gotta tell you, this is pretty dull, you know?
Dull?
Yeah. I mean, here we are back the same place, the last place that you saw. I mean, that's such standard police procedure.
You were expecting something else?
Yeah. You know. Use your powers. Little.
Adam, I told you, I'm not going to do that.
Sure you don't want to take a peek?
I'm positive.
Lisa?
Maybe you could let him know if you find out anything about Matthew.
Not to worry. Mac and Rachel will do that.
Yes, you're absolutely right, Ada. Listen, I've really got to go.
Okay, thanks again for the ride.
Oh, you're more than welcome.
Take care.
I will. I'll see you guys later.
Bye. Bye. She seems so happy these days.
Well, that's more than I can say for Vince.
Okay. Okay, I'm going to do something about that.
Hi.
Did you get a special price on those tickets when you bought them?
You want me to cash yours in?
No, I just don't want to see you get penalized when we change the reservation.
To when?
Anytime soon, so that we can be there and back before I have to start work.
You really want to do that?
That's what I've been telling you. So what do you say?
Well, I have to, you know, see if I can get the time off.
Oh, gee, I'll bet you can do that.
I'll call the airline. How long will it take you to get your affairs in order?
Not long at all. Sooner the better.
Look, I told you, you shouldn't call me here. No, you just shouldn't. You know I want you here with me. Yeah, just as soon as I get a few things straight. I love you too, baby. Yeah. Bye.
Lisa, what is it?
This door wasn't closed when I was here before.
You getting an impression?
Adam, I do remember things just like other people.
Sorry. Lisa? Lisa, I'm in here!
Jamie? Jamie, how did you manage this?
Well, you won't believe me even when I tell you.
This lock's jammed.
Well, is there something around here we can pry it open with?
Wait a minute.
Oh.
Watch this.
Did you learn this at the police academy?
A police academy? Are you kidding? I saw this on Miami Vice. There you go.
Vicky.
Boy, am I glad to see you. Hi.
This explains your mysterious disappearance. Oh, Adam, you do not know how good it is to have friends in the police department when you're a missing person. I never thought we were going to get out of here. I was going crazy. Just imagine how terrible it was for you.
Look, if you've got some things, why don't you collect them and I'll walk you back to your car.
Yeah, okay.
Now listen, I know that you think this supports your theory about Vicky. You know, and I have to admit that it certainly crossed my mind when those doors slammed shut. But if you had seen her fit of claustrophobia, you would have known that nobody could fake something like
Jamie, if you think this is just one of those crazy coincidences, you... Forget it. I don't want to discuss it here. Let's go. Thanks for your help, Adam.
Anytime. I'll see you at work tomorrow.
Jamie, thanks.
Hey, it's okay.
Their book spoke of time travel, vampires, and angels. And if you missed any of them, count on SoapNet to bring back poor Charles. Coming up next, revisit their stories with back-to-back episodes. Only on SoapNet, the new way to watch soaps.